Hey everybody, so have you gotten that Google Ads limited by budget alert in your Google Ads account? You know, you may be wondering what that means and what you should do with it. And so in today's video, I'm going to be discussing what that Google AdWords limited by budget red alert means and what you should do with it. Hey everybody, I'm Richard Cruz. I'm the founder of WSI Priority Media. The purpose of all my videos is to help you with your Google Ads, your YouTube ads, and to help your business to thrive. And if you're running Google Ads, you must know already that budgeting is one of those things that you absolutely have to keep an eye on. Got to make sure that your campaigns, your ad groups, everything is just running really, really tight. Google can be a little sneaky when it comes to telling us that we need to raise our budgets and our bids. And one of those ways is this Google AdWords limited by budget. And so what Google is telling you is to adjust your marketing budget to increase it so that you can get more impressions and clicks. So the only thing is that there's no definite explanation from Google of how they're coming up with that calculation. And before that, you just jump in and start increasing your bids, you need to know, you know, where your budgets are at and how your campaigns are performing. So when you get that limited by budget, you know, what do you do? So if you have the money to spend, the best, the easiest way to obviously resolve that is to increase your budget, which is what they're asking you to do. But only if you have got a strong ROI that is right within the parameters that you want. It's all about the ROI when you're running ads. And so what you want to do is make your calculations based on the lifetime value. If you've optimized the campaign and you've got it to a point where your ROI is strong, then don't limit yourself if your investment is profitable. If you invest $1 and you get back $4, for example, you're making money and it's time to scale your business. But don't make the mistake, what I see many people do, is that they do it based on the one-time income. You can't do it that way. You have to really spend time and make sure that you understand what your lifetime value is of your customer. Let's say that, you know, the average sale is $600 and you know that the average customer will wind up coming back. They'll buy multiple items. There's upsells, there's cross sells, and there is referral business that, you know, for every so many customers, you'll get a new customer. All that is lifetime revenue. And so what you do is take that number and calculate what your real lifetime revenue is. So that 600 may have a lifetime value of, say, $1,600 for every new lead that comes in. Now you know what you can afford to pay. What I see most people do is that they have a $600 revenue and it costs them $500 to acquire the client, and they stop their ads because there's no way that they can make money. Your smart competitors are calculating their lifetime value because they're growing value in their company, they're scaling. And so they'll be glad to pay $500 because they know it's making them $1,600 and they can run and grow a business at that. So make sure that you're starting with your lifetime value when you're assessing, because many times if you're just doing it at the one-time value, you're going to find that there's no way that you can get past that limited by budget error. So the first thing to do is, if you're not there, if you're at that point where your ROIs, you know, haven't gotten there, you need to start really being careful with your campaign. And so some of the things that you can do, for example, is to decrease your bids. When the budget's a little bit closer to hitting the limits, this strategy may get you more clicks. It may get you better CPA. However, the downside to decreasing your bids is decreased average position also. So you have to be really careful with that. So when doing this, I suggest that you monitor any changes, especially a decrease in position. If your position is dropping, you may find that your CPA is starting to increase and it may work against you. It's a balancing act that you have to be really, really careful with. Second item is to change your ad scheduling. So if your budget is limited, if you change the way that your scheduling is, let's say that you're paying for 24 hours of leads, but you're only open from 8 to 5. If you can convert more customers by answering them live from 8 to 5, well, you don't need that whole budget. You can decrease it to the lower level. And that's a great way to stay inside of the Google optimized parameters. Number three is be specific in your ad text. This should be common sense for those who are running ads, but sometimes it is not common sense. I see so many people that forget the simple logic when you're running ads. The importance of being specific, being direct, and being clear about your ads and that it appeals to the right audience. You can get really good quality clicks when your ad is exactly what the customers are looking for. And so you take your search term and you match your headlines and your descriptions to talk about that. And not only do you do that at the ad level, but make sure that on the landing page level, you're carrying the scent all the way through as well too. You'll find that that really helps you with better conversion, which will help you with the limited buy budget. The next item is to strategize your ad location. So the same logic applies here, all things not being equal. For location, not every location is equal as well. So just exclude locations or limit locations that are not as profitable. We often run multi-location campaigns and we'll run the same strategy, the same ads, the same bids, and the same headlines. And you'll see certain offices that will perform extremely well and some that are not as profitable. And so if you're limited by budget, focus on a per location basis and see where your money makers are, increase in the ones where you're making money, and you can start scaling back on the ones that are not as profitable, and you can retweak that strategy to try to get something that's going to work better for you. The next item is bid adjustments. Using your bid adjustments, just simply adjust those bids, you know, where they need to, so that you can try to get, you know, within more profitable, get more leads by adjusting those leads, and that'll help you around that as well too. And then the next item is the use of negative keywords. As I said earlier, not all keywords are created equally, so you need to be specific when it comes to bidding of keywords and make sure that you're not bidding for generic or ones that are just too broad or really not related to your service. For the keywords list in your campaign, you just go in there into the tools section and look and see what's happening. You'll often find that it's starting to go astray. And so you may have your keywords optimized, but as Google is learning, it's bringing in certain terms that may not be related. And it's like a garden. If you've got weeds that are coming up, you just keep pulling them out. You may have a lot of budget that's wasted on keywords that shouldn't be in your campaign. And if you use the negative keyword tool, you get them out of there, and that gives you more money to spend on more real campaigns. And Google doesn't think that you need to go after all that unrelated stuff. And so make it a habit to always check things, to question and to evaluate everything. Test in your Google account. Keep an eye on your keywords, on your ads, your campaign settings, and find ways how you can save costs, improve your conversions, improve your ads, and then anything that brings in more profits to you. Paid search, Google Ads, is not a step-by-step or a smooth process. It's about testing and optimizing and then testing and optimizing again and again to find those profitable campaigns, those profitable ad groups, those profitable keywords that are really working for you that you can use inside of your ROI, and then you can scale up. When you do, Google Ads is going to be a great revenue source for you, and hopefully you'll want to keep giving it more and more unlimited budget, because you give a dollar, you get $4 or $5 back. It's like a piggy bank, and it's unlimited what you can do and how you can grow. So make sure that you try these ideas out. Think outside the box and watch everything. And so that Google Ads limited by budget is just a good sign for you, because you know it's time to strategize and figure out what your next steps are and hopefully continue to grow. Hey, if you have any questions, reach out to me anytime at wsipriorityMedia.net. And if you found this video helpful, like it, give it a big thumbs up, share it, and subscribe so you're alerted of future training videos.